little bit behind the sort of reason behind your visit to Greenside today and why you think it's important to talk to young people about film.
When I was doing a play in the summer, I met Karen and I thought she was an incredible teacher and an incredible inspiration. And then I started working with Interfilm. I was really struck by their message and how brilliant the idea of using film to communicate really well with kids. So that's why we're here.
Do you have an acting style or method that you use?
I didn't go to drama school, so I never sort of learned, you know, like a lot of people when they are actors, they go to RUD or Central or a drama school and they kind of learn a technique or a certain kind of way of doing it. But because I kind of started quite young, I really just sort of learned from watching other people. So I've kind of figured out my own way of doing things, and it's different really from job to job.
What would you say to any of us who are aspiring to be an actor or an actress?
You know, a lot of it is a game of luck, and I think what I would always say is it's a really great job, but you know, you have to sort of, sometimes it's down to being in the right place at the right time and try and, you know, really just focus on your education and then, you know, think about acting when you've left school, because I think the main thing about acting is you need lots of experience and you need sort of lots of life experience.
Did you do much acting in primary school?
I did, yeah, but I did, I liked doing musical plays when I was in primary school, so I liked singing, and my first play I did, The King and I, when I was about 6 years old. I never got the lead parts though, so that was annoying.
What's the best thing about being an actor?
One of the best things is getting to work with lots of really fun people, and you get to spend time with them and you all become like a big family, and I love watching all of these people do their jobs because everyone's so skilled at what they do and there's so many different elements that make a really good film.
How did you feel when you got your role in The Great Gatsby?
The director called me up and the first thing he said to me was, "Hello, Daisy." And I just burst into tears and I had sort of, in the middle of this room of lots of really fancy people, just completely lost it. So, yeah, I was really excited.
Do you feel as though the different roles that you play represent a different view of females in society?
Gosh, that's such a good question. I think it's important to tell female-driven stories, and so much of the film world is dominated by stories about men. And so that's sort of part of what I want to do, is trying to get more films made about women's stories.
Do you have a favourite actor or someone famous who inspired you?
Leonardo DiCaprio on Gatsby, because he's so famous and he's this sort of film icon, and he was a really committed actor. He was really kind to everyone. It's really important that the lead actor in a film is really nice to everyone who works on the film and treats everybody the same, and he did that.
What's the favourite film you have made and why?
Pride and Prejudice was my favourite film because it was my first film and it sort of introduced me to lots of people the same age as me, and we had a really fun summer and I just sort of had to run around giggling, so it was great.
When you were a child, did you have like a film which inspired you and sort of wanted you to make your favourite film when you were a child?
I think my favourite film was Mary Poppins. Oh, is that popular here? Oh, yeah. Yeah, so I think because Mary Poppins had music in it and I really wanted to be in musical theatre when I was younger, that was why that was my sort of favourite.
What did your parents want you to be when you were grown up?
I don't know what they wanted me to be. I think they just wanted me to be happy and do something that I liked. I think they were a bit nervous about me being an actor because it's quite a tricky job sometimes, and it's sometimes quite difficult to make a living out of it.
If you weren't an actor, what job would you do behind the camera?
I really like editing. I think probably because I want the power that the editor has. But I think editing is a really interesting job, in going through all the footage that you have and trying to tell the story in the best way. I think that's sort of the side of it that interests me the most.
Did anybody go and visit you at school, anyone from the film industry or an actor, and how was that? Did it inspire you in any way?
Yeah, when I was at school, right before I left, Julian Fellowes, who wrote Gosford Park and also wrote Downton Abbey, he came to my school and did something a bit like this, and he talked about all the different sides and writing and editing and cinematography and all of that stuff, and that really kind of got me excited about film.
Okay, well, I think you'll all agree it's been fantastic speaking to Carey today and learning a bit about her job and sort of seeing from the inside what it's like. So can we all please give Carey a big round of applause?